Welcome back. Satisfactory update 7 in the Northern Forest. So, picking up where I left off, which was making 10 oil generators, which has given us a lot of power to the network. I've let quite a lot of time pass and I haven't seen any spluttering, so it appears that I've got that all piped up correctly and all that. Now I'm still sinking 180 rubber per minute, just going straight into an awesome sink. Just haven't got a use for it yet, so might as well make some tickets for me. I'm just trying not to get overwhelmed and give up again, so I've also done a little bit of cleanup too, where I had I still have the computers and circuit boards coming back this way into a box. It's now being smart split, where the computers go into a box, circuit boards go left into a box, and to the right, if either box overflows, the right goes into a sink as well. So that will keep our refining setup over here going non-stop if things are just going into a sink. So still have not done anything with this yet. I'm just leaving it as is. It's just racking up reinforced plates and modular frames for me, basically. But I have a to-do list for the next few episodes. This one is going to be focused on setting up packaged fuel and unlocking that jetpack, because I just can't use zip lines. I can't be fucked setting up hypertubes. I just want to keep these recordings going without doing too much off camera. So that's the first thing. I was just making sure I've got everything I need to do that on me. Another thing will be setting up the automation of AI limiters. What was that? No, that's my empty canisters. Yeah. And then moving on from there to high-speed connectors. So I will need to set up caterium mining soon. And then just drag it all over to a copper mine. What I am going to do with this copper mine here, which I mentioned at the end of the last episode, is they're on pure nodes on Mark 1 miners, so they're giving 280 ore. I'm going to upgrade both of them to Mark 2 and cut the miner that's just in this box here, and then either send it out or actually spin at 180 and have a copper factory that way. That way it kind of merges up with the caterium that's sort of out that way a little bit to the south of where I am. So that's the plan going forward. So for this one, definitely setting up packaged fuel, and if I can make a start on circuit boards, which would mean a quick change of that, like I just said, and heading out to the caterium spot. But anyway, let's get started on getting this jetpack milestone done and setting up packaged fuel. We'll just head down here. I don't know if I've shown this little pathway that I've made off. Ooh, that's the first time that happened. Yeah, I really gotta get that jetpack. I've only used one before when I found it on a hog, but I had no fuel. I can't remember if I've automated, if I've made packaged fuel before. I think definitely from this point on, apart from not making caterium quartz or sulfur mines yet, pretty much going through these milestones now and everything I'm doing, I've never done before, so it's all new to me. So I'm going to come back here, and this is where I'm going to do fuel. So currently, everything is set up to give me the exact amount of plastic only to make circuit boards and computers. There's my motor factory. I believe I was overclocking these a tiny bit. Yes, well, not a tiny bit, quite a lot. Let's get the numbers here. Some of these are overclocked and underclocked. That's underclocked. No, some of these refiners are underclocked. There was one plastic and one petroleum coke. Yep. And then all the petroleum coke is just getting sinked. That's right. Tickets are right. I think I've got 35 still up, so I've got 50 tickets. Nice. Okay, so. I need 40 fuel per minute. So space. Head out this way, I think. And these two are merging just here now. I could pinch some crude from here into a little packaging setup just over there. So. This foundation here to roll across for a sec. I'll roll my clipping on. One power line. And if I'm quick. Shouldn't hurt too much. Right, and this will be the platform that I'll build off. Except I want to go this way, I think. And then I think of it. Yeah, I just cut all that out. Alright. I think 6x6 should be enough. Kinda inadvertently giving myself a way to hide these pipes at some point too, which is kind of a good thing, I suppose. Just get a flamethrower or something and just torch it. I need to go out one more. It's 210. Good. Let's clear all this out so I can see. dealing with here. To me now. I'm good. That's up there. Alright, now, time to work out the numbers. So, empty canisters. 20 plastic per minute gives me 40 empty canisters, which means I need 40 fuel from that. So, hang on, let me get the plastics out first. I'm not going to divert plastic back around from that underclock, I'm just going to leave that alone for now. So if I start with a refinery here. Let's go. Pipe's going to come in. In the corner. Halfway across. Just there. Right, we're going to make plastic. You're not going to do it like that. I need 40 fuel, so I need 60 heavy oil residue. Going into a packager. I need that 60 heavy residue. Reside. Ugh. Spelling's atrocious. Plastic. This is fine, I just need 30 crude. And it's going to give me 10 on the side, which means I just need to drag over 50. Okay. Let's get the crude set up. 50. How much are you intaking? You're intaking 40. What are you intaking? 2.5. Okay, now if I can divert 50. Hang on. That's given me the exact amount of plastic I need. I also need a... So the plastic... I think I... weirdly... spin that refinery. Heavy oil residue actually clipping on that? No, not that I should be. I'm not worried about clipping too much, as long as it's nothing egregious. If the game lets you do it, it lets you do it. So, whatever. Right, so that's going to pump out plastic, giving me the empty canisters. I merge. Giving me empty canisters. Plastic for the empty canisters. So if I put the constructor. Leave a bit of space for now. Empty canister, and you're going to go down to. Straight into that, giving me empty canisters. I've got to feed the crude around to the back of that. I've got to pull 50 from here to merge into this. To make 60. Now, where would I put the refiner? The packager. I think. Keep the pipes simple. Probably on just here. Is it straight? Yep, it's on that line, it's straight. 1, 2, 3, 4. Really, the only thing is this. Right, and I just move that As long as too much of it doesn't clip. Just trying to jump on top of this. There we go. Finishing on that line. Out. Package fuel, 40 per minute. Have I skipped a step here? Heavy oil residue. I've skipped a step. I have, yeah. Need 40 fuel, 60. What have I skipped? A second refinery, I think. Converting. Converting. That's why I'm pulling. Yeah, okay. Second refinery. Yeah, just fill it. Fill up. No, leave it. I'm not moving that. jewel. Empty canister. Okay. Put the packager here. Just like a constructor, just one tile. Except I'm going to go forward half a tile. Absolutely horrendous. Stupid. I mean, that looks a little better. This, I need an extra 30 crude per minute. So, leave them exact. Now I need to get that crew over there. can't get up. Come on. Up you go. Oh, it's so fucking close. How much crude is it? 30. Just so it doesn't fuck up the other stuff. We're going horizontal to vertical, good. That's a bit. I've got those, I didn't purchase them yet. I don't know if, hang on, there's an awesome sink over there, and I'm sure I can build an awesome shop. Right on the circle of that dot. Oh, cool, you can do it like conveyor lifts. Now that makes life easy. Yeah, it's round. Probably won't let you. Pipe has an embellishing. Okay. We are going to clip through that. Really, it doesn't let you walk on it, does it? Fuck, that's annoying. It's a good thing I've kinda sorta gotten into the habit of only building with 1 meter foundation, because that would make these crawl spaces horrendous.
Thank you.
going to run at 81.25. Heated. Okay, you're not heated. The crude is set up. I need power. Crude oil. Shouldn't you be filling? Or don't you fill until the power's on? Daytime mode only in this, if I were to make only one request to change about the game, it would be that, and only that. I actually don't know what the controller in the code was actually used for, so I'll just leave it. Okay, well, not pretty much fuel, so I'm going to drag it back home like this. to the... One thing done. Alright, now we're just going to drag it back to base. Deal with those rat looking things too. What are they, rat lizards or something? So 32.5. How much packet fuel is it? 40 per minute, okay, so. Oh, yeah, I can do that. I can split it further up the line. That's fine. One AI limiter, please. Actually, give me two. Make sure that they go through. Yeah. Computer's still going to go through. Here comes all the packaged fuel. Yep. Awesome. Just wanted to speed that up, just to fix it, if needed, which it did need fixing. And how many have I got? I've got 100 on me, don't I? Yep, that's enough to do the milestone. Okay, cool. Right, I'm going to merge up with that, head up there, so let us go back. This milestone done, and finally I've got access to the jetpack. Proper access too, not just what was found on the back of a hog. Here's my little sync operation. I'm going to cut you and move over there. No overflow for the time being. Before that packaged fuel gets here. That's fine. Oh, wait, hang on. Right, so overflow and right package fuel. Here it comes. fuel and left is overflow. Dead center. Okay. Just a little bit. It's almost here. Alright, none's coming down, so let's get around and have a look. I didn't cut the belt properly. Fuck yeah. Alright, finish off this side. I forgot you gotta cut the belt. Conveyor belt is too stiff. Was attached to it just before, for fuck's sake. Alright, package fuel to the right, everything else straight ahead. Fuel to the right, the overflow. Working. I don't think I've ever done anything that... that might be a lie. I think I've done more complex, but that was pretty complex. I'm sort of cheating the smart splitters there. So that is that refinery, just over there, that's doing all the stuff to make computers and circuit boards, and now packaged fuel can just run until the end of time. No backfill at all. It will all get awesome synced eventually, and I just realised that at our current speeds that needs to be 1.2. if overflow does become a thing. Alright. Milestone time. Separate boards and computers I don't need. Alright, jetpack.
R&D inflated your pocket dimension and has provided a jetpack, which operates on oil-based fuel, for increased navigational capabilities as well as odds of survival.
Cool. How do you make a jetpack? Oh, I do need 15 circuit boards. There you go. I've got no idea how these operate. I know you press and hold space, and away you go. So I've had enough of you. What? I ran out of fuel. How does it work? The jetpack allows pioneers to travel through the air with increased control. Consumes fuel when used and automatically refills the fuel from the inventory. Oh, when on the ground, okay. Alright, so. It's actually not enough to fly 24 meters up. It's still pretty cool though. Because now I can go. Oh, this is a game changer. Sweet, and there's the handsome motor factory to finish off the episode. Very nice. Actually, I'll go back to the hub. Oop. Oh shit. It's like a half second delay once you start going down. We'll keep that in mind. What's the next milestone? Trains. Q. They're being fully automated. Hand feeding modular frames. Let's do it. Next episode, unlock trains. I will hand feed to get myself 100 modular frames. Heavy modular frames. Learn how to use the jetpack. can do it while sliding, so you can give yourself some good momentum. Nice, I've actually got everything I need. Alright, cool. Thanks for watching, that's it for this episode. Let me go back here. I did say, let's finish off here. Having a look at the motor factory. There we go. Ooh! That's pretty funny. Nice. Alright, sweet. Jetpack and package fuel fully automated with no repercussions whatsoever in terms of backing up any sort of line. There we go. Next, I start learning trains. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.